Yeah, blood rushed in my head, they hot lock popping off the fucking block. Now clocking wristlet, watch been top off.
You think this is funny? You think this is a joke? Well, joke's on you. This is my new intro.
Yeah, blood rushed in my head, they hot lock popping off the fucking block, not clocking wristlet, watch been thought about.
Okay, so before we get into the game, play video, I'm going to ask one thing, and one thing only, and that one thing is, please play the game before watching this video. If you haven't played the game up until now, I would suggest doing so. You can buy it on Steam, you can also... Oh my god. You could buy it on Steam. It is called Spec Ops The Line. You could also get it on Xbox 360 or PS3. But yeah, I highly suggest playing the game and finishing it before watching the rest of this video. If you don't want to, that's fine. But you won't understand it as much as you would if you did play the game. If you were watching this to figure out if you wanted to play the game, it would kind of ruin it for you. But so, yeah, I would suggest playing the game before you watch the rest of this video. Hey guys, today I'm going to be playing a game called Spec Ops The Line, which I think came out in 2012, if I'm being honest. I don't remember. I do remember seeing trailers for it when it came out. I'm probably way too close to the mic. So I'm going to step back. Okay, so yeah, we're going to be playing Spec Ops The Line today. From what little I know, it's just a third-person shooter, cover-based combat and whatnot, like Gears of War and whatnot. So it's probably gonna be pretty generic in my opinion. But hey, that's why I'm playing this. I kind of want to know. So I'm just gonna go with suicide difficulty. It shouldn't be too hard. I mean, what's the worst that's gonna happen? Is that a helicopter? Oh shit! There's helicopters in this game! Wait a minute, hang on. Ow. Is that Nolan North? Well, I mean, since he's in it, it might be a good game. But who knows? It's like a really dated Nolan North. This is back when he, like, kinda did Deadpool. You know, this actually reminds me of a game. Yeah, this definitely reminds me of a game. That, came out not too long ago. I'd say around 2011, maybe November. Is also war themed. Generic shooter. You know what I'm talking about. Skyrim. Boom! I guess you could say another one bites the dust. No. Wait, what? Man, where the fuck are we? Wait, are you insane? Yes, I agree. Are you nuts? There's no way in hell that we're gonna survive in fucking sand. Okay, what the hell, man? What kind of starting level is this? Like, I absolutely don't know where we are. I don't know what's going on. I don't know who these people are. Like, this is not a very good first. Oh my god! So, before I played this game, I actually did a little bit of research, I Googled Spec Ops The Line, and most of the results that came up were comparing it to Heart of Darkness by Joseph Conrad and Apocalypse Now. Now, I've seen Apocalypse Now, and I've read some of Heart of Darkness. And so maybe I'm really hoping that it's nothing like either of those things, because if it is, I'm not going to have a very good time. Okay, so from what I can understand from the intro, or the beginning, that helicopter segment happens, it hasn't happened yet, as far as this story is concerned. Right now, this guy, Conrad, the Conrad is the leader of the 33rd, I think. And this guy, Captain Walker, and his two subordinates are
yet to be seen, Sergeant.
Are going in to save them because Conrad. I don't know if I explained this. Conrad, it was in Dubai trying to save the people caught in the sandstorm, which is a big sandstorm, I'm guessing. And so these guys, so they haven't heard from Conrad in a long time, so these guys were sent in. Well, that was ominous. It said starring Dish Reckoning, which is me. Anyways, so these guys are supposed to go in to see what's up and to rescue any of the people that need to be evacuated. So that's the story so far.
Rocket Man.
Rocket Man. Sorry, I actually just watched the Rocket Man trailer. Someone built this out of spare parts.
Any idea who?
Well, I mean, I seriously doubt that you guys have any idea who it was, since it doesn't seem like there's anybody alive there. My guess is that everybody's dead. Just like that. I'm guessing that everybody's already dead. This is going to be a walking simulator. I just know it. Every we fight ghosts in this game. It's confirmed. We fight ghosts. Wait, what? I mean, if this works the way I think it does, this is actually kind of cool. Oh my god, that's cool! That's so cool! That's an interesting mechanic, okay. So this is a little bit different from third-person shooter. I think this was made with Unreal, so maybe it is different. I don't know. So far, it seems to have a pretty decent story, but I kind of can't get over the gameplay. I don't really like I'm not a huge fan of cover-based shooters. The music kind of sounds like Tool, which is very odd for this kind of game, because Tool is more of like a... I don't know how to explain it. For anybody who's listened to Tool, you should probably know what I'm talking about. They're different from any other kind of rock. It's like borderline psychedelic rock. So, like, naturally, with this kind of game, you'd think that they would use, like heavy metal or that kind of stuff. Something to pump you up. You know, despite the fact that everybody seems to want to kill us, at least we're inside. At least there's that. Ceasefire. Surrender. Your nearest outpost for processing. Processing. We now return to our regularly scheduled Psychomantis? Here we go. Let me go on record and say this shit just got weird. Bitch! Weird. This has been weird. And you know it. I mean, look at the art on the walls. These people have lost their minds. 33rd, my ass. We need to leave. All these signs are pretty much screaming that we should leave.
16 paranoia-filled days later.
You know, I began this video...
It's over.
Oh, look, an achievement. I began this video... I'm sorry. With all jokes.
Time to go.
And, criticizing the game. But playing through it, getting to the end, is very enjoyable. I did like the gameplay.
We drove through this whole city to fight.
I did like the, don't mind me asking. The gameplay, the controls, like? The cover-based shooting.
How'd you survive?
Because it worked. They made it work really well.
Who said I did?
I don't know how to explain it. They made it work really well, essentially, is what I'm trying to say. You know, for a game that was based off of the book Heart of Darkness, it wasn't really all that dark.
It all returns to nothing. Forget the past. You can't forget love and pride. Because of that, it's killing me inside. Oh,
Commander, this is Falcon 1. I think we found him. Captain Walker.
He's armed.
It's okay. Hold your fire.
I don't understand. What's he doing?
Look at his eyes. Something's not right.
Captain Walker, we are here to help. But first, I need you to lay down your weapon.
He's not complying.
He's shell-shocked. Give him a second. Just hand me your weapon, Captain. Take cover!
Remember back in Kabul, John? Before things got bad? We were talking. About nothing, really. I said something about going home, and you... You said...
Home? We can't go home. There's a line men like us have to cross. If we're lucky, we do what's necessary and then we die. No. No, all I really want, Captain, is peace.